Hey, right. Lend my voice to your bull crap.
That's right.
And it just wasn't necessary. Because here's the deal, too. I wanted to see how much rope I could give him and how many times he would actually stretch it around his throat and everybody else in that room's throat, you know, and before I could yank on it this morning. I couldn't wait to get on the show today, Bob.
He does that for fun.
Yeah, you know, the whole premise, I mean, there wouldn't be a bar in this town because they'd all be shut down, or a bar and grill, I mean.
Of course.
You know what I mean? Because...
Because then nobody could go to Applebee's, and nobody could go to Red Robin.
Right.
Nobody could go anywhere.
Right.
Chili's, whatever.
Right.
Can't even, you can't.
Right. Some of the crap, it was just, I was absolutely stunned. And listen, I know that Dan says stupid things just to get people's ire. I know that's part of his gig. But sometimes he just says, not just stupid things, but hurtful, idiotic things.
Mm-hmm.
You know? And I'm just like, wow, I was embarrassed for him yesterday. I really was. I was embarrassed for him and all of his little panel of wannabes that are in there yucking it up, you know, and it cracked me up. Some of the callers that were calling in, the one that really got my goat was this bar owner,
mm-hmm.
who I knew who it was because I recognize his voice.
Yeah, you know what? I know who you're talking about.
Yeah, and he didn't use his real name.
Yeah, used a fake name. Said his name was John. His name isn't John. Wouldn't say what bar he owned. Right then and there, I'm sorry, I'm hanging up on you.
Right.
You are not credible.
That's right.
If you don't want to tell me what bar you're, but you're going to call and represent.
It could be anybody.
Right. And then
how do I know?
Then he makes up all these numbers about how liquor licenses are there, and then he spouts out what Rum Runners, you know, does percentage-wise. How the hell would he know?
Wait a minute, though. You sure that guy's name wasn't John?
Oh, no.
No.
It's not John.
It's not John. I know who you're thinking about. It wasn't that guy.
No. I know who it was, and I know what bar he's a part owner of too.
Of course.
And I also I know how tall he is, which ain't much. He's a little dude.
Okay.
I used to call him Little Napoleon. He's one of those guys that all he would do was talk about chicks with me, which kind of made me believe there's something else going on.
Right.
But I just thought it was really funny that they'll take that guy as a credible witness into how bars operate.
Right, and see, that's the other thing that I was saying. I mean, what he was saying was basically would shut down half the bars in this town that serve food.
Oh, yeah.
Of course.
Yeah, and here's the thing that cracks me up is Rum Runners is not a bar.
Right, it's a bar and grill.
Right, exactly. It's in the name,
and
people.
Its designation is restaurant.
It's restaurant.
Right.
And you know what's funny is, last night, Thomas Van Flynn went in there. He took a bunch of pictures of three different families with their kids eating dinner.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, give me a break.
Yeah.
You know, and the thing that's funny is listening to Fatboy yesterday, he's all pissed off because no one's calling him back and no one's giving him the information he wanted to. Dude, your show doesn't start until, what, 2?
Yeah.
So you had all day to make a couple of phone calls yourself.
Yeah.
And get the information you need, but you chose not to. You'd rather go on the air and just make up crap.
That's right.
And then get pissed off when you can't get a hold of the people that can set you straight.
Yeah.
I just thought the whole thing was a joke.
Yep.
Yeah, I agree.
Well, I appreciate you listening. And to me, and I, you know, I was talking to because Lori is out of town.
Mm-hmm.
My girl from Channel 2. And I told her, look, man, your company is really blowing it on this one. They really are. They're buying into it. They're buying into the tabloid journalism that's going on here. No one's making the right phone calls.
Yeah.
No one's asking the right questions. They're all buying into this BS.
Right. Are they a journalistic organization or are they TMZ?
Correct.
That's what they need to
and
decide.
And I told her, I said, you know what the real story here should be? Is how fast a little tiny nugget of crap can turn into something when there's nothing there because the last name Palin's involved.
Mm-hmm.
That's really the story here.
That's a good story.
Right. That's the story. If this was Bristol Smith, no one would have been talking about it.
No.
Exactly.
It never would have been an issue.
Nope.
And here's the thing, too, Bob. It's not like we snuck her in the side door.
Nope.
We advertised it, for Christ's sake,
for
three full
days.
We talked about it, I mean, nonstop. If it was such an issue, why weren't they there that night? Why weren't they there beforehand?
Because they're lazy.
Well, because
there's no story.
Right. I mean, that just cracks me up.
God, man. That's what ticks me off. I get...
It makes me laugh. It makes me laugh. But you know what? God bless them, because it's people like that that make us look so smart.
Yeah. You know what, Bob?
I appreciate
that. I'm going to say something.
Let's hear it.
No, I'm going to say it.
Go ahead.
Lay it on.
No, I'm going to say we are smarter than journalists in this town.
Yeah, I believe
we
that's
are.
True. I believe that's true.
Wholeheartedly believe that.
I believe that's true.
And Dan Fagan is a tubby bitch.
You can't say that. Thank you, Bob.
Chuckle, dude.
Right, I appreciate your call. Right, I said I was going to play a country song. I lied.
Really?
Well, I'm going to have to play it after this commercial break.
Oh, okay.
All right. Well, no, I can't because Nova hasn't put the traffic in yet. So here's what I'll do. I'll play a little snippet.
All right.
From Mr. Dan Fagan's show yesterday. Okay. And this is mild. Mm-hmm. This is mild compared to where it went to.
Oh,
listen to this.
Yeah.
We're talking about Bristol Palin Gate, where she was at a bar.
Bristol Palin Gate. I love how he is so quick to attach gate to anything. Mm-hmm. You know?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, really?
Boarding late at night without her mommy and daddy. Maya Nolan, is it Maya Nolan?
Maya Nolan, yeah.
Are you there, Maya?
Now, I want you to listen to this. Maya Nolan was on his show because they told her one thing and then switched it on her. Listen to this.
I'm here.
And
hey,
you covered this story, correct?
Well, I wouldn't say that I covered the story. First of all, I was promised that we were going to talk about Dancing with the Stars.
No.
Shannon.
No. She lied to you.
Well, you know what?
Well, we're talking about Dancing with one of the Stars.
That other Nimrit voice you hear is Craig Medrid.
Right. Big dumbass.
another spot-on journalist.
Oh, yeah.
I was lured here under false pretenses. I wouldn't say that I covered the story so much as an investigator from the ABC board showed up at our offices with a flash drive and said, hey, could we have your footage from Rum Runners? And we said no.
So do you know what the limitations are for a 19-year-old and being in bars late at night or what time Bristol was there? And
now, why would he ask her?
Yeah, what does she know?
What the limitations are with liquor licenses?
Because at the very beginning, she said, I really wasn't on this story.
Right.
I just cover the entertainment.
Don't you
aspect.
Think if you really wanted that information, you'd, I don't know, called a couple hours earlier in the afternoon?
Yeah.
And asked somebody?
My answer would have been, what the hell are you asking me for?
Right.
I told you I covered Dancing with the Stars, not the legalities of the ABC board. That would be my boss, Ms. Coyne.
That's funny. What do you know about what's the liquor license there at Rum Runners say? How the F would I know that? Why are you asking? How would I know that?
My understanding is, and I don't know exactly what time she was there. My understanding,
of course,
is that if a place has a restaurant designation, that a minor can be there for the purposes.
Well, then what does that mean, restaurant designation?
Why are you asking her? You should have found out what that means.
That just makes me laugh.
Means it's a restaurant.
Excuse me, you, a lady that covers Dancing with the Stars. Can we talk about the legalities of restaurants in Anchorage?
What is a restaurant designation?
What? What are you talking about? It's like Elton John, please. Let's talk about the vagina.
Yeah.
I don't know much about it.
Well, let's give us your perspective on it.
Let's talk about it anyway.
I'll tell you my perspective on it. Ew.
Ew.
Again, not an expert on the state liquor laws.
Because
at all.
If you're talking about they have a designated area that is nothing but a restaurant.
Now, here we go. Here is the self-appointed expert.
Yeah.
Dan Fagan.
Here he goes.
All right. Expunging the laws of the liquor land here in Anchorage, Alaska. Here's the expert.
That would be Chili's. That would be Applebee's. That would be Friday's. That would not be Rum Runners.
Oh. Well, there you go.
A man who knows nothing now knows everything.
And it just gets worse. That was mild.
Dude.
Oh, it gets better. Who's just on the phone?
This is Greg.
What's up?
Hey, Bob. I called him yesterday too, and told him about the motocross calendar girl.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
It took place there, and there was dozens of minors.
Yes,
my son included.
Yes,
so, but you know
he doesn't care.
Of course, no. He doesn't. Listen,
you know why he
facts,
doesn't?
Facts get in the
yeah.
way.
Yeah, right? You know why he doesn't care? Because it involved girls.
Exactly. Good point.
Yeah.
Good
right,
point.
Guys.
No, you make a great point, Greg. I mean, we hosted the Motor Girls search there for 5 weeks.
Sure.
And
yeah,
every single Tuesday night, there was no less than half a dozen writers that were there that were 16, 17, 18. They weren't there with their parents.
No.
There
right.
was no legal guardian.
No.
They were eating dinner. They
That's
weren't
right.
drinking beverages.
Because it's a designated restaurant.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yep. And there was no law broken. I mean, no. there's just, oh, my
yeah,
God, Greg, this whole thing just made me laugh.
Well, yeah, laugh after the fact, but at first it was.
But it's embarrassing. I was embarrassed for him. I'm embarrassed for him today.
Yeah.
It's embarrassing. What a scumbag.
He was cool.
I appreciate the call.
All right.
Thank you very much. All right, 629 Country coming up next.
Bob and Mark.
Yeah, well, sure, but I mean, it hardly means like I'm a member of some super intelligent race with extremely advanced personal hygiene.
Alaska's war.
So far as this Bristol
Palin
thing, who gives a crap?
Well, I mean, you know,
people who hate the Palins.
Right. See, here's the thing. There's not a whole lot of people out there that are protecting the Palins. The, you know, on in the media, there's not a whole lot of them.
No.
All right?
No.
Especially locally. And I tell you what, I stand by this. Nowhere on this planet, okay, other than maybe the Middle East, is Sarah Palin and her family mocked and ridiculed more than in Alaska.
Yes.
And
it's
disgusting. I'm embarrassed by that.
It's totally disgusting.
And I get there are liberal parts of the country. You know, the Northwest is fairly liberal. And they're not real fans of Palin, but at least they're semi-respectful. Here in Alaska, she gets treated like dog crap, mm-hmm. and it's really embarrassing. And this whole thing, I guess, that pisses me off about this whole Bristol thing is they have an opportunity to celebrate with us that an Alaskan is doing something cool.
On a national stage.
On a national
Absolutely.
Stage in front of millions and millions of people.
Absolutely. The number one show it was
right,
last week.
Right, to over 20 million people across the country.
And last week was premiere week. They beat the crap out of every network premiere.
Right, and there's our Bristol from Alaska.
Beautiful.
Take away the fact that her mom is Sarah Palin. And I know if you take that away, she's not on the show. I get that. I get that. But the fact that she's doing it, and doing well,
yep,
and having the courage to get up there. I wouldn't do it. I tell
no,
you,
I wouldn't.
And especially knowing what she knew going in, that people are going to blast her. She yeah. did it anyway. She says, screw it. You know what? Life is too short. I'm going to have yeah. fun doing it.
And you know what was great? The beautiful thing is it burns them so much. Even the first week when that one Carrie Ann Inaba said, I expected you to fly.
Right.
And you did great.
Right.
I am so excited for you.
Right.
Yeah. Well, hey, we should be thankful Fagan didn't do Dancing with the Stars, because that would have killed the ratings right in the butt.
Oh, my God.
Well, I don't know that he would qualify.
He's on no. Dancing with Buffets.
Dancing with the Steaks.
Yes.
Now, listen, we're hard on the old boy, and you know what?
He deserves it.
On this one, he really does deserve it. It was just disgusting.
I heard him whining yesterday on the radio.
Oh, and every mention, he knows absolutely nothing about our show.
No.
Nothing.
Right.
And he'll categorize us. He'll go on about us. And,
right.
Yeah.
Oh, he can't mention
his skull.
Bob Lester won't comment. Bob Lester hasn't called
yeah.
us.
yeah.
Bob Lester wasn't going to give him the satisfaction of being on his program again. You know, it's not my job to validate anything that guy says.
Yeah.
It's not.
And by the way, Dan, I've lost 23 pounds in 11 days.
23 and 11, huh?
Yes, yep. sir.
All right. Well, good deal. I got to get on that because I got a few days before I go down there.
Yeah, it's a great
yeah.
program.
Do it.
Yeah.
All righty.
All right, Dan.
All right.
Yeah, you guys have a good.
Thank you. All right. The phone number in the Valley, by the way.
Yes.
There's Alaska Weight Loss Institute out there in the Valley. It is 357-5677 in Wasilla.
Yeah.
That's 357-LOSS. Call the Alaska Weight Loss Institute.
The science of this program is there.
Yeah, it works.
It works. To me, I figured out it's three parts.
Yeah.
The science is it. It's on you. So you follow this deal,
right,
and you will maintain the target weight you set for life. You will.
All right.
That's it.
Without further ado.
Yes, sir.
God dang it. Hold on.
What? Are you doing it? Or what?
No. Who's this?
Hey, good morning. It's Robert.
Hello, Robert.
Hey, Robert.
Could you imagine if it was Mark Begich or Hollis French or the ugly Betty girl from ADN?
Oh, yeah.
And Dan Simmons says how they would celebrate. Say, oh, what a great thing for Alaska.
A great triumph for Alaskans.
Yeah.
Of course.
And nobody else has done anything like this.
Right.
Bristol does
of
it.
Of course.
Like, yeah, let's get her in trouble.
Right. Well, yeah. Here, and I'll make the analogy again, Robert. This isn't the first time. And here's what I think is, first of all, Rumors is a restaurant. Okay, she had every legal right to be there. She didn't break any law. They didn't break any law. End of story. Back in 2000, a 19-year-old and I were at a bar, bona fide bar, not a bar restaurant, a bar.
Yes.
Having fun.